What's up, GBA?
Happy assembly. Ava.
Yes?
What has a mouth but doesn't speak? What runs but never walks? What has a bed but doesn't sleep?
A river?
Nice job.
All right, now I have one. What gets wetter the more it dries?
A towel, Ava. I'm a master of riddles.
I am too. You're going to start on the announcements now.
Okay. So we have flag with second graders. Isn't that amazing?
After that, we'll have Mr. Howell for character focus.
And we'll have Teens Run Modesto with Mr. Austin, Mrs. Allen, and Mr. Thun that will acknowledge kids that participated.
Last week's birthdays with a special surprise at the end.
And Miss Kona with Quest for Kindness. That was really weird. Okay, GK, okay. Stay safe. Wash your hands.
Wash those hands. Okay. Bye, GBA.
Bye.
Pledge allegiance to the flag, United States of America, and to the republic of which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, for liberty and justice for all. Right hand over your heart, ready, begin. As a GBA student, I promise to be kind in all I say and do, to be safe at all times, to do my best at home, at school, and everywhere I go, because it's the right thing to do.
Happy Friday, GBA. Hope you are healthy and happy this week. I have the privilege of recognizing the students who went above and beyond in this week's character focus. And this week, we were focusing on encouraging our parents. Your parents have really had to step up in a new way the last 8 weeks to help ensure that you are not only safe and healthy, but that you are learning while not being able to come to school. And so we've all had to learn and adapt and work hard to make this season go well. And your parents especially have had to step up. And so I hope that you took some time to appreciate your parents and let them know how much you have benefited from their help and their support during this school shutdown. I happen to have in front of me the names of many, many students who went above and beyond in expressing appreciation for their awesome parents. And I would like to recognize them now. So even from where you are, feel free to clap and cheer and wish well these amazing students. Give it up for Isabella Aguirre, Gerteg Mann and Kirat Mann, Valerie Victoria and Milan Vargas, Julian Ballesteros, Mallory Samuel and Maylin Myers, Mason Crutchfield, Jenna Villegas, Annalie Gutierrez, Declan Dayland, Zachariah Plata, Jordan Garnica, Imani Holm and Delilah Marrero, Emma Olivia and Sierra Dormer, Mita Bangu, Taylor and Olivia Park, Wesley Slosson, Ayla Bodeker, Kashira Joy Ba, Imbaladi Tahani Kudus, J.C. Lewis. Lost my place, people. All right, here we go. Zachary Brown, Peyton Hillen, Kylie Lohman, Sophia Serrato, Nora Wagner, Alexander Freeman, Alexander Kona, Jackson Matthews, Darby Howell, Stella Vaughn, Maya Stein, Bailey Thomas, Samira Das, Dylan Bledsoe, Lily Higgins, and Emma Gay, Logan Lavender, Vivian Zavala Lopez, Michael Ortiz, and McKenna Pryor, Adam Clausen, Jojo Messer, Aaliyah Perez, and Nicholas Rangel, Annabelle Bravo, Wesley Slosson, Rhett Haley, Evan Waltrip, Mateo Patterson, Andrew Ribeiro, Zachary Brown, Ailsa Kroom, Delilah Marrero, Taya Moraine, and Tylee Sage Moraine, Travis Garcia Gale, Michaela Huizar, Spencer Chirabel and Chase Scroggins, Annalie Gutierrez, Jordan Vasquez, Sophia Aimiwu, Mateo Patterson, Natalie Benton, Iris and Emily Rodriguez, Joel Galvan, Isaac and Ellie Mishler, Junior Evans, Ellie and Mitzi Cook, Wyatt Barajas, Gravir Saini and Jasmeet Saini, Valerie Victoria and Milan Vargas, Jeremiah and Emmeline Werner, Bella Martinez, Graham, Adelaide, and Celeste Sonajera, Isaiah and Arabella Bolden, Osi Latu, Giovanni Madrigal, and Azalea Foster. Wow, so many kids going above and beyond and expressing gratitude to their parents for all of the great work that they're doing. That is fantastic. That is hugely important that we thank the people who are investing in us and helping us. GVA parents, you got to know we really respect and appreciate all the work that you're putting in to make this time successful for your students. And we're very thankful for the opportunity to partner with you in that. Great job. Let's talk about next week. Next week begins the beginning of the final 3 weeks of our school year. And so I want to start encouraging us to focusing on finishing strong in these final 3 weeks. It's been eight. In some ways, it's gone really fast. In some ways, it's been kind of tedious and kind of hard. We have 3 weeks left. And what I don't want us to do is quit or stop before the race is over. I want us to finish strong, to break the tape, to feel good about what we've accomplished during this entire 11-week period. And that means that we can't stop now. We got to start talking about how we finish strong and how we finish on a high note. So that's our character focus for this week, is to finish strong. I'm proud of everybody's effort. I'm proud of all of you. We miss you. Keep up the hard work. Stay healthy. Stay happy. We'll see you again real soon.
Morning, all of you amazing Great Valley Academy Salida students. How I miss you guys. I miss seeing you around campus. I miss seeing your faces. I miss all the hugs. But this is the next best thing, our Friday assemblies, where we get to connect and you guys can get to see what's still going on. One thing that we did this year, and we've actually done it for the past couple of years, is called TRM, and it's stands for Teens Run Modesto, and it is a running mentoring program that students, they start out, and we start out running shorter distances, then we end up running longer distances. And if you are participating in TRM, you are one of the hardest working athletes on campus, and they do amazing things. It's a 6 month long program, so if you're committed to it, you're committed for the long haul. Like I say, we start off with some short runs, 2-3 miles, and we culminate with a 13.1 mile half marathon. And this year, because of the corona thing, everything was going on, our half marathon was canceled, so we couldn't go downtown and run on the course. But many of our students ran that by themselves, and we took videos of them and everything like that. And for today's assembly, Miss Allen, Mr. Thumb, and myself would just like to acknowledge and honor some of those students and all of the work they did. Like I said, over the course of 6 months, we probably put in 300 to 350 miles total running. And I just want to take some time to acknowledge the effort and the commitment that these students take. I'd like to acknowledge Micah Vanetta, Elisha Hernandez, Austin Glover, and a couple of our homeschool students, Ace and Emma Basil. Anyway, this is the shirt that we were earned. And like I said, many of our students went out and earned it on their own. And this is the medal that we got. And I just wanted to say congratulations to all the students who participated. I'm so proud of you, all the work that you did put. And I can't wait to see you next year.
Hey, GVA family. I hope everyone is doing well, staying healthy and safe. I'm here today to talk a little bit about Teens Run Modesto, the program that we have at school where we train for a half marathon. We had a lot of kids this year join. We had a lot of sixth graders, which was really exciting. I just wanted to say how wonderful it was to be with you guys and train with everyone. It was such a learning experience. We had a lot of fun. a lot of hard times as well, but I'm so proud of everyone that was involved. I know that COVID-19 kind of took our half marathon experience away, but I'm proud of everyone who persevered and still did it on their own. I want to do a shout out to a few of the kids that were part of the team. The first one is Molly Allen, my daughter. I'm so proud of you. You definitely persevered and got through it. I'm so, so proud of everything that you did during TRM this year. The second person I'm shouting out is Ava Beth Bennett. Way to go. You did so well. You had your goals, your times, and you always crushed those goals and always tried to do better each run. The next one is Taylor Kowalski. I'm so proud of you, Taylor. You did so well. You definitely persevered and pushed yourself. You did so, so good. I'm so proud of you. The next person I'm shouting out is Alan Padilla. Alan, way to go. We definitely had some interesting runs this year. I'm so glad that I was a part of it and that we could run together. It was always great when your dad came out as well to run with us. That was really fun. So way to go. The next person I'm shouting out is Nathaniel Longoria. Nathaniel, you were amazing, so fast. You ran and just killed those times. I'm so proud of you for doing so well and just persevering. I know that it was hard sometimes, but you did it. The last person that I'm shouting out is Kylie Lohman. Kylie, way to go on your runs, way to persevere again, way to always show up, always have a smile on your face, and always do your best. So those are all of the kiddos that I'm shouting out, but I'm proud of every single student who came out, who put in those hours and hours and hours of running so that we could be ready for our half marathon. Way to go.
What's up, everybody? Mr. Thumb here, and I want to congratulate a couple more of our TRM runners. First off, I'd like to congratulate Landon Smith on this amazing season. You were one of the first to go and complete the half marathon on your own when everything was starting to get shut down. And really proud of you, bud, for staying consistent, pushing through, and doing the thing and run your 13.1. Good job on you, buddy. I also want to thank Dominic. He did an amazing job. You were constantly pushing yourself and doing your best. I think that's all I was really asking for you guys is trying your best, pushing through. Even when we did like an 800 meter lunge walk, everyone cried and complained about it, but you did it, bud. And you were constantly pushing yourself. I'm really proud of you, Joel. Always pushing through, always had more energy than I think you realized. And I think that's an amazing job in and within itself. You did amazing, bud. Abimel as well, two of these Sixers. Abimel did amazing, constantly up there. And this is the thing, Joel and Abimel were running faster than I was. So, hey, consistency. And they were doing great out there. I'm proud of you guys. Really, really proud of you guys. And last but not least, I want to congratulate Nathan Puck, who from last year to this year PR'd on his time, and I'm super proud of you, buddy. I hope you do well in high school, and if you decide to cross country and track and all of it, I hope you do amazing. You are an amazing runner, and I'm just super proud of all you guys. It's too bad we didn't get to finish it off with the actual race in March, but all of you did do it on your own, and that's all that matters, and I'm proud of you guys. All right, Mr. Thumb out.
We were born ready, ready to be free, chasing every thrill we could see. With our eyes steady, waking to a dream, aching to be thrown in the ring. If nothing comes easy, as long as we're breathing, we'll go all the way or go home. We were born ready, wherever it leads, what we have is all we need. Cause if it's fast or slow, all I really know is I'm gonna enjoy the ride. And if it's hard or soft, before we get
parents, get up, kids, get up. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Don't run out of time. I got my unicorn slippers on. I'm ready to get my dance.
Ice cream and cake.
Furby1, or you can also hit me on Facebook to Miss Valerie's Dance Parties for Kids group. See you guys later.
Hey, GBA, it's Mrs. Kona, and I'm here for Quest for Kindness, and I'm feeling a little like a superhero, and not just because I'm wearing a cape, although I am wearing a pretty awesome cape. This one is my Wonder Woman cape, and in addition, I have on my Wonder Woman shirt, but not just Wonder Woman. I also have Ms. Marvel, and Batgirl, and Supergirl, and Black Widow. Giving the love to the DC and the Marvel. So, first thing, it was Teacher Appreciation Week last week, and I hope that you appreciated your teachers. And I did hear about a class that definitely appreciated their teacher, and that is Mr. King's class. Mr. King loves skating around. He loves skating around, but his skates needed an upgrade. And so his kids and their parents got him some new skates. And since getting them in the mail, he has been skating all over town. He's just been like skate, skate, skating. I've been seeing all the videos of all of him just skating around, skate, skate, skate. My Quest for Kindness ears perk up. And I'm like, that's awesome. Thank you for appreciating him that way. And thank you for being kind. And let's go ahead and give Mr. King's class a howl and a clap. There's a student in Mr. King's class who also sends him work. You know, because in this distance learning, of course, you got to send your teacher work, sends him work, but not just work. Also sends him little notes of encouragement, little drawings, things like that. And I got to see that some of those. And so that's a nice way to appreciate somebody for a little drawing to make them make their day. And it is. He told me it is making his day. So let's go ahead and give a howl and a clap to that student. No, I'm sorry. This week I've heard from Mrs. Cole this week. Saying that there is a student in her class she's in kind of a weird quarantine situation. Sometimes people are quarantining away. Sometimes people who we normally live with are quarantining somewhere else, and that student is in this situation, and some of you probably are in that kind of situation too. But that student in Mrs. Cole's class has two big brothers that go to GVA, and those big brothers, one of them is in Mrs. Brewer and Mrs. Dykstrom's class, and one of them is in my class. Those big brothers, though they have GVA work of their own to be doing, are helping their sister do her work too, making sure she gets all of her stuff done. Her dad is helping her get all of her stuff done. And so when those kinds of, when family members come together to be kind and to, you know, just really come together, that is a nice thing. So let's go ahead and give those students a howl and a clap. I'd also like to say, and I don't know the answer to this, but there is somebody at GVA who made sure that our eighth graders, those kids who are graduating this year from GVA and are going on to high school, felt really special. And they took it upon themselves to be really kind. And in the dark of night, they put little signs on their lawn saying, "We appreciate you. We believe in you. Go out and do great things in high school. We love you." And so I would like to give a howl and a clap to those, because I heard about this a lot. There are a lot of parents and students who feel awesome being recognized like that, that GVA and somebody at GVA took the time to put these little lawn signs out so that those graduates felt really good. Those kids, I also feel really special about those kids because those kids are the kindergarten class when we first opened Manteca, you know, way back in 2011, when we opened Manteca, those were the kids who were my kids when I was the director of kids care. And so we do love those kids. We do hope wonderful things for them in high school. We do expect them to do great things and keep on the GVA kindness. And so I would like to give a howl and a clap to those kids who are graduating and also to those people who made them feel special by putting those little lawn signs in. Let's go ahead and give them a howl and a clap. Okay, so that's it for me. I know you're out there doing kind things. If you have something that is happening that you see that is super kind and you want to tell me about it, you can email me, a.cohn@greatvalleyacademy.com, or you can tell your teacher during a Zoom meeting to email me. I would love to hear about the other great things you're doing. So keep being kind, GVA, and I'll see you next time.